Right, so for today's video, we're going to take a look at multiplying by 10, 100, or 1,000. So when we've got questions like these, we can actually use a place value diagram to help us out. So when we multiply by 10, 100, or 1,000, we're actually moving the digits in our number to the left of the decimal point. And the amount of times we move the digits is shown by the number of zeros in the number that we're multiplying by. So when we multiply by 10, we move the digits in our number one space to the left because there's one zero in the number 10. When we multiply by 100, we move all the digits two spaces to the left. And when we multiply by 1,000, we move all the digits by three spaces to the left. This would also work for our large numbers like 10,000, 100,000, and even a million. But these are just the examples we're going to look at today. So for these first questions, we're starting with the number 7.2. So I'm going to write that number into my diagram first. I've got 7 in the units column, I've got my decimal point, and then I've got my 2 in the tenths column. So for the first question, we're doing 7.2 multiplied by 10. So because we're multiplying by 10, this number is going to get bigger. So we're going to move all the digits one space to the left. So to begin with, I'm going to put my decimal here. I'm going to move my 7 one space to the left, so it goes from the units column to the tens column, so it'd now be here. And now I move my 2 from the tenths column to the units column, so it'd be here. So I've got 72, then my decimal point, so the answer is just 72. Okay, for the next question, we've got 7.2 multiplied by 100. So because we're multiplying, this means we're going to move our digits to the left. And because we've got 100, it has two zeros, we're going to move all our digits by two places. So we're going to put our decimal place in there. So now our original 7, which was in the units column, is going to move one, two spaces to the left. So now it's in the hundreds column. Our 2 for the tenth is also going to move two spaces to the left. So 1, 2, we'd take that to the tens column. And now working back to the decimal, we don't have anything for our unit, so I need to put a placeholder in there of a zero. Now we've reached the decimal point, we can stop, so our answer to that is actually 720. Okay, and for this last question, I'm going to first put my decimal point in here, and now I've got 7.2 multiplied by 1,000, so that means we've got to move all the digits three places to the left, because we've got three zeros in 1,000. So starting with our original 7.2, our 7 would move 1, 2, three spaces to the thousands column, so that would be here. Our 2 would move 1, 2, three spaces to the hundreds column, so that would go there. Now we don't have any tens or any units, but we still need a placeholder to show this. So we'd have a 0 in this column and a 0 in this column. We've now reached the decimal point so we can stop, so our answer to this question would be 7,200. So now for this next lot of questions, we've got 0.03. So I'm going to write that in the top row. I've got 0 in the units, our decimal point, and 0 in the tenths, and 3 in the hundredths. So for the first question, we've got 0.03 multiplied by 10, which means we're going to move all the digits one space to the left. So I'm going to put my decimal in here. So starting with that top row again, our original number, if we move all the digits one space to the left, this 0 in the units would now be in the tens. The 0 in the tenths would now be in the units, and the 3 in the hundredths would now be in the tenths. So all I need to write for this answer is that one 0 in the units column, 0.3. So our answer to that 0.03 multiplied by 10 is just 0.3. Okay, so when we multiply by 100 this time, starting with the original number in the top row, we're going to move all the digits two places to the left. So that 0 in the units is now in the hundreds. That 0 in the tenths is now in the tens, and now that 3 in the hundredths is now in the units. And we've reached a decimal point so we can stop there. So we've got 003, which is just 3. So that'll be the answer to that one. And then finally, with our last question, we've got 0.03 multiplied by 1,000, which means we're moving all the digits three places to the left. So starting with our original number in the top row, the 0 that was in the units, we're now going to move it three places to the left, which means it's now in the thousands. We're going to move the 0 that was in the tenths three places, so now that's in the hundreds. And now we're going to move the 3 that's in the hundredths three places to the left, so now it's in the tens. So we need to work our way to the decimal point now. We've got no units, so we need to put a placeholder in there of a 0. Now we've reached the decimal point, we can stop. So we've got 0030, which is just 30. And that would be our final answer to that one. So hopefully this makes sense of how we can move our digits around the decimal point when we're multiplying by 10, 100 and 1,000. I've got a few more questions for us to have a look at. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these. And we'll go through the solutions in just a few seconds. So for our first question, we've got 0.123 multiplied by 10. So we know because we've got 1 0 in 10, we're going to move all the digits one place to the left. So if we move all the digits one to the left, we can see that that 1 is going to make it over to the left-hand side of the decimal point. So if we jump all the numbers one place to the left, we'd actually end up with 1.23. Okay, for part B to this question, we've now got the same number, 0.123 multiplied by 100. So this time, because we've got two zeros, we're going to move the digits two places to the left. So if we move the number twice, well, we've already moved it once in the first example. If we move it again, we can see that the 2 is going to make it over to the left-hand side of the decimal this time. So if we do that, we'd end up with 12.3. And then part C to this question, we've got 0.123 multiplied by 1,000. Because we've got three zeros, we're going to move it three places to the left. So we can see the 1 would make it over the decimal point, the 2 would make it over the decimal point, and so would the 3. So the answer to this would just be 123. Okay, and for our final lot of questions, for part A, we've got 0.5072 multiplied by 10. Again, we know now when we multiply by 10, we move all the digits one place to the left. So we can see once we move that over, the 5 will actually make it over to the left-hand side of the decimal point, and then all the digits after will be on the right. So for this first question, we'd have 5.072. For part B to this, when we multiply 0.5072 by 100, we've got two zeros, so this is actually going to move all the digits two places to the left. The 5 will make it over to the left-hand side of the decimal, so will the 0, so we'll have 50.72. And then for this very final example, we've got 0.5072 multiplied by 1,000. Again, because we're multiplying by 1,000, we've got three zeros. We're going to move it three spaces to the left. So the 5 will make it over the decimal point, the 0 will make it over, and so will the 7. So we'll be left with 507 on the left of the decimal point, and then we've still got the 2 on the right. So the final answer to that one would be 507.2. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.